What is up, everybody? It is a Blue Drake, and today we are going to be taking Steam by force. I am going to be live streaming our game, Iron Armada, and throughout this entire time, our game is going to be live on Steam Greenlight. Links are down in the description. So if you want to go, click on that, and then go visit our page. Hold on, let me see if I can find it really quick. Primary display. There we go. You will be able to... Hopefully, if you want to see Iron Armada on Steam, upvote us. And then if you want to follow development, follow it. If you want to favorite development, I don't know what that means, but you can favorite it. And leave a comment saying how much you hate me. It's whatever. It's natural. And then, most importantly, if anybody wants to participate in this game, you can download Iron Armada right here, right now. The link is in the description of the Steam Greenlight page. So after you hopefully go upvote us and tell the world how much you want to see Steam Greenlight be on the front page of Steam, or else you can grab the Iron Armada client and play with me right now. Honestly, that is the reason we made Iron Armada. I wanted to make a game where I could just boot into a game and all my fans can just join and we can battle each other without having any serious issues. That's the kind of game that I wanted to play. So that's what the kind of game this is. So you can go download it and play it right now. Go do it. Do it. I'm waiting. Okay. All right. Good. So besides that, we are going to be playing on the open server. Hopefully you will be able to get a taste of what the game is going to be like. Throughout this entire time, we're going to be listening to the official soundtrack of the game, which is being written by my guitarist Kyle and myself from Jahari, which is really, really cool. It's really nice. This is a game where so many different people of so many different skill sets who I have built a network with and have become friends with and family with for over my lifetime. It's so cool to see all of these different people's skills and talents culminating in this one single game. Like, I really think that's special. That is what I love most about game development, honestly. Screw everything else. Like, it's watching people's talents come together to make something really cool and meaningful to them. That's the best thing. So anyways, without all that sappy bullshit aside, go and blitzkrieg Steam Greenlight for Iron Armada. Please upvote us. Let's get on Steam. Let's do it. I will not stop streaming until it happens. Well, obviously, I'm going to stop streaming. I don't think they do another Greenlight batch for a while. So, I'm going to have to stop eventually. But I'm probably going to streamlight? I'm going to stream for a while with Greenlight until, I die of exhaustion. Okay, so we're going to enter our name here. We're going to join really quick. Bam. So, for those of you who do not know what this game is about, hold up, let me start the soundtrack. This is Iron Armada. We don't have a sound artist yet, by the way. So, if you do sound and you're good at it, please hit me up. Seriously, I desperately need sounds. This game needs sounds. So what Iron Armada is, if you have played Faster Than Light, the game Faster Than Light, Iron Armada is inspired, very similar to Faster Than Light, except instead of being single player, it is multiplayer. And instead of you being on a fixed ship design, you actually get to build your ships from scratch. In fact, you don't just get to, it is the main focus of the game. It's more like competitive shipbuilding, honestly, as opposed to something like Space Engineers, where it's just fun to just build your ship and be in a sandbox. You have two teams. There is a red team and a blue team of a lot of people all competitively building their ship, mining resources from asteroids, adding on weapons, building weapons, designing their ships to outmaneuver and outfight enemy ships. You can build anything you want. You can build a large mothership. You can even get off and you can build an entirely separate fighter, which is what we're going to do. We're going to build like a scout fighter. Let's see here. Reactor. That. Get this online. Actually, I think I'm going to take that out. And another cool thing about Iron Armada is all of your designs are physics-based. So this is actually something that I don't think a lot of people know. If you were to go play Space Engineers right now, and this game is it's inspired by Space Engineers. Our community played a whole bunch of Space Engineers. But if you were to go on a Space Engineers right now and make a bar like this long, and if you were to put a thruster on the end of that bar... Oh shit, I'm gonna get destroyed. No, you're destroying my demo! God damn it. Well, okay, let's do it here. If you were to take this bar I'm out of scrap. God, this is shit. This is destroying my entire showcase of the. Hold up, just.
On the dark. Somebody,
they're above us.
Somebody help me make this point that I'm trying to make about space physics or something. Here, I'll do this.
Oh my God.
Okay, like no, space I'm gonna physics? Do it. Okay, I'm gonna do okay, it. Okay, here we go. Wait. All right. So, if in Space Engineers, if you were to make a large plank like this, and you were to put a thruster at the end of that plank, and then fire that thruster on, you wouldn't turn. It wouldn't torque the ship. It would just move it forward. That's because Space Engineers has kind of a fake physics system. That's one of the reasons you have gyroscopes in Space Engineers, because you can't actually use physics. Oh, God damn it. Here we go. To turn your ship. Whereas in Iron Armada, physics is critical to the ship design. So, for instance, if we're fighting here and I want to have a tactical advantage against this ship, if you take out his left thrusters or his right thrusters, what happens is he loses the ability to turn in that direction because he doesn't have the thruster. There's no magical gyro. There's no magical anything. You have to build your ships from the ground up to work with. It's kind of like, it's almost like Kerbal Space Program. It's kind of like competitive, like 2D, obviously. We don't have huge planets and stuff like that, but kind of like a 2D Kerbal Space Program here. Actually, you know, now that I have get these. There we go, finally. Now I actually have resources. Wait, hold up. I'm gonna
do that
hey,
first.
I'm gonna steal reactor. Everybody chill, all right? I'm probably gonna steal these chill? Two engines too, and I'm gonna steal these armor. Sorry. Just shh. Okay, so anyways, if we were to take this reactor here and make a ship out of it, let's build a thing here. Oh, thanks for the extra reactor. Put a thruster there. And you'll see when you fire on this thruster. Oh, sorry, hold up. Shh. Build. There we go. It spins you in a circle. So this means if you build a ship and it's not symmetrical, that's actually kind of funny. If you see all the ships in this game, they're all symmetrical. People aren't building the ships symmetrically because it looks cool. They're doing it because they have to. If you don't have a symmetrical weight distribution, your ship is completely screwy. I mean, this is the reason everything is symmetrical in real life. Ships are symmetrical, fighters are symmetrical, all those things, because you need even weight distribution. But now, since I have two thrusters. Hold on, let's just. If I fire them off, well, actually, that one's. You know, it's funny. This is actually even better because the left arm is a little bit shorter than the right arm, and you'll see I have a little bit of a bias to the left. So I'm actually gonna take this, put another one. And now that we have even distribution, I can go forward. Now, this actually gets even cooler because since we have this a real physics system in this game, that not only affects design, but also combat, you'll see things happen like this. Hold up, shit, go away. I'm trying to do it, there we go. Sorry, infantry are trying to take me on. Check this out. If you actually have thrusters that are too close to the center of mass, and you try to use these to turn, come on. Let's go. There we go. Nope. They will not turn you. Let's actually get rid of that. It's much slower. A much slower turning rate. As opposed to if you build it out here. Oop. Very fast turning rate. And this comes into consideration with your ship designs. This, when you have multiple people on your ship mining resources, building the ships the way you need them to be built, you're going to have to keep your ship designs in mind. And even later on in the game, hopefully one of the things we're going to be able to do is players are going to be able to design ships offline and then bring them into the battlefield at the start of the game. You're going to have ships with different designs that are just going to be more effective at different ranges and stuff like that. All right, so this is actually kind of like a tutorial ship, so this is not going to be very effective. Oh, okay, so there's the enemy team. And look at all those people on that ship. This is the main thing that we wanted to do. The main thing we wanted to do with Iron Armada is you've got a lot of games out there that are really big and they're 3D and they're beautiful. But with all of that complexity and all of that, you know, beauty also comes a lot of technical challenges, which means if you try to have multi-crew ships and stuff like that, sometimes the game just collapses under its own weight. You know, you have networking issues, you have physics issues. We wanted to create a really, really simplistic game, just two-dimensional, so it's a lot easier to implement things like multi-crew functionality. If you'll see, you know, I've got people walking around on my ship right now. There's no lag, there's no latency issues, and that's because it's a lot easier to polish these systems, to polish these multi-crew systems and stuff with a simpler 2D game. So that's what we wanted to do. You know, we wanted to take everything back to its roots and give everyone the gameplay that we've always wanted, which is like multiplayer, multi-crew spaceship battles. And even if we have to do it in 2D, it's not a big deal. We'd rather have that multi-crew spaceship battle in a 2D and have it be stable and have the gameplay be good than... Shit. This is not good. Okay, so you can see he just blew off my left thruster, and now I'm kind of like biased to the right. Oh shit, come on. Oh, he's trying to run. Kill him. Alright, so let's just build a better ship. Hold up, this ship is garbage. We've got two reactors, so that actually gives me a pretty good chunk of power. You actually do have to manage your power pretty effectively in this. Alright, I'm just gonna unmute.
And then we should probably
is this blue
have
team?
Chat
is this better be blue team,
yes.
Or I'm gonna be mad.
Right.
Yeah.
Yes.
No, this is red team.
This is blue team.
Is it?
Shut
up.
This is blue team channel.
Alright, red team move to blue team channel, or fuck. You know what I mean? Everybody move to your right channels!
We're in our right channels! Why are you here?
Oh, no, this is the blue team.
I'm the blue team.
Are you... Oh, goodness.
What?
Yes.
Sorry, just find an enemy ship.
Fire.
You're shooting
all
a medium on your side.
Fire.
I don't care.
Okay, we're killing victory laps.
Get on people. Get on repairs, guys.
Alright, so I've got myself a nice little fighter here. This should be good for just salvaging and scouting. And he's got kind of like a nice little Corvette. I guess tacticals.
You missed every shot!
Don't worry, we're fine.
Behind you.
He doesn't have guns, we're fine. He has no guns.
Just roll with me, tactical. Alright, so tactical is running Corvette with me. And this is why we kind of wanted to call it Iron Armada, because you're going to have, like, multiple ships. Like, there is... How many people on this team? Holy shit, there's a lot of people on this team. And this is just two of us. So we've got an entire Armada across the map. Here, there we go. Let's go rendezvous with that carrier over here. Once, you know, Redneck gets out of the way. There we go. He has a much better ship than I do. In fact, honestly, I have all these reactors and I'm just wasting them. Oh, right. I forgot, because I don't have any scrap. Well, hold up. I can... get these repaired. Come on. Turn online. Go online. There we go. Oh, shit. Oh, I lost the mothership. Okay. We're going to go find that mothership. You can get Iron Armada on BlueJake42.com, or actually just go to our Steam Greenlight page. You will be able to get the download there. Okay, so there's a battlefield here. Oh, looks like these guys just engaged some kind of red ship and just destroyed it. Oops, I just hit that little piece. So you can see, you know, in this game, you're going to come across different ships, and they're going to have their own designs, and they're going to have their own crew. You know, you can see all of these different crew members doing different things. You've got Marines on, and these are all players. None of this is AI. These are all players playing right now from our community. And all of these different players, you know, have different roles. Some of them are pilots, some of them are engineers repairing the ship, some of them are Marines protecting the ship from enemy players that are trying to board, or enemy Marines and stuff like that. You can actually have Marines and use the Marines to board enemy ships, so you could, like, ram the ship against another enemy ship, and if you have enough Marines, you can tell them all to go get on board. And there's no lag, there's no issues. Like, if the ship moves, you're not going to glitch off the ship. Nothing bad is going to happen to you. That was one of the big things that we wanted to ensure of. Like, if we're going to have multi-crew gameplay, we want it to be the most stable multi-crew gameplay you've ever experienced. I mean, that's one of the reasons we wanted to make it 2D. Like, we think stability is more important than just, like, beauty. And honestly, this game's actually really gorgeous. Here, actually, you know what? Let's talk about that. Let's talk about the gorgeous factor here. I'll let somebody take over. Hey, Tactical, can you take over ship design and just build this up? I'm gonna go AFK for a second.
Tactical's not in this Discord right
now.
Who is? Sullivan, you here?
Nope.
Who is that? Ottavan?
This is Red Team Discord.
Oh,
this is Red Team.
Yeah.
You've been Red Team.
It's blue.
There we go.
They have
tactical,
short range guns.
Tactical, can you take over, just take over ship design for now? If you could.
Ship design?
Yeah, I'm gonna go AFK for a second. Just take control of my ship.
Alright.
Thanks. Alright, so let's go to my Dropbox. Development. Iron Armada. Where is it? And then also the other Discord. So let me get the source code channel up. Where are you? This is a live stream, so I apologize for taking a second to get some of this material together to show you, because I'm going to be showing you some of our artwork. So right now, this is the game. The game is very simplistic, like this is very pre-alpha-y. Obviously, this is not how the game is going to look, hopefully, down the line as we continue developing it. All the blocks are just one by one. There's no 2x2 blocks or anything like that. Everything's very simplistic. You can see the interiors all the time. I want to show you what the game is going to hopefully, well, I don't want to say hopefully, because I mean, this is all our art, look like in the future. So, here's some of our upcoming artwork. Iron Armada in the future, we don't want it to just be kind of like a blocky kind of thing. Like, the ships are going to look like ships. You're going to have a variety of different armor blocks. Not necessarily that you, like, scroll through and place, like, a corner armor block or, like a diagonal armor block. Like, a lot of these armor block placements are actually going to be dynamic. So, instead of you having to place, you know, for you know what, let me just show you. So, right now, in this game, this is just kind of a prototype system, but you'll see if I add armor blocks, they'll automatically merge. So the artwork will merge and it will look different if you have different configurations of armor blocks. This is just a simplistic system, and we're going to evolve this as time goes on. So you can see, like, armor blocks that are facing a corridor block get that little white line along the edge. If a wall block is placed next to another wall block, it merges, so it creates, like, a single seamless line, stuff like that. In future versions of the game, we're going to be taking that one step further. So you're not just going to have, you know, one large wall block that merges with another large wall block. You're going to have diagonal blocks that automatically merge with one another and stuff like that, so you can create really beautiful looking ships, but with a really kind of like simplistic parts. So you don't have to sit there and be like, all right, I'm gonna put a diagonal wall block here, I'm gonna put another diagonal wall block here, I'm gonna put a half diagonal 90 degree wall. Like, it's gonna be much more automated, much more seamless. Another thing that we want to do with the game, for instance, you know, one of our big things, we're big fans of FTL. We want this game to not just look but also play like FTL, just in multiplayer, and also with the ability to blow off every single part of your ship. And we also want teamwork to be a big aspect of the game. So as you can see here, with this design, this is kind of like just a strike Corvette, and it's got a rail gun on the front. And in the future, we're gonna have multi-blocks, so you'll be able to place down like one single large engine or small thrusters, maneuvering thrusters, stuff like that, or, you know, integrated afterburners and stuff like that. We also have a here's artwork for a why can't I think of it? An airlock. So we'll actually have airlock systems. One of the things that we're looking into doing is having oxygen systems, which should be, I mean, I'm not making any promises here because I don't want to no man's sky anything, but at the same time, we already have a system that scans the area of the ship in order to figure out if the ship has been split in half or not, and it's very similar to something that we could adapt to use for, like, oxygen. So, for instance, you could blow a hole in the ship, and then all the oxygen would vent out. We already have a system that should easily just be adapted to accomplish that. We already essentially do that for block destruction and ship splitting and stuff like that. And then another thing is, right now in the game, when you place down down turrets, the pilot has the ability to kind of like control those turrets remotely. But in the future of the game, we want to have a variety of different weapons. So you're going to have fixed weapons that the pilot controls. You're going to have turrets that you're at, like heavy cannons and stuff like that, that players actually have to walk around inside the ship and get into. Hopefully we'll also have things like, here, actually, let me see if I can, we have so much like prototype artwork. And the funny thing is all of this is actually our artwork guy, Lucas. He's literally just been taking all of our blocks in our sprite sheet and just putting these things together. So all of these blocks are literally like hand put together. This isn't like one giant hand-drawn piece of art. We have like a giant list of different blocks that you can just compile. But let me see if I can get another picture here. Oh yeah, here we go. So here is a picture of another prototype ship. And you can see there's different kind of weapons here. There's like machine gun turrets and stuff like that. Some of them are going to be manned. Some of them are not going to be manned. Some of them are going to be remote control. Some of them are going to be automatic. Another thing that we've been working on is you can actually see these damage sprites. So if a ship gets shot up, these damage sprites will be littered across the ship. This is kind of an advanced, an example of like our advanced artwork system that we're hoping to employ down the road. You can see like little decals and stuff here. All things that are dynamically generated. So for instance, this decal could be placed somewhere else on the ship. These little separate damage markers and stuff like that can also be placed anywhere on the ship where it gets shot. So you can see like this engine's a little bit beat up and this engine's kind of like beat up in a different way. But something that's really important that we also want to talk about is a prototype system that we're working on, which is ship externals. So not only are you going to have these ship interiors, but if you're actually not on board a ship, you won't be able to see inside of it. You won't be able to see where the crew are and stuff like that. So you can see this variant has two airlocks on the side, and then the interior of the ship is actually covered, so you won't be able to actually see inside of it. And you know, here's a variant with that is uncovered. Here's actually some different this is a different variant of the same man turret that actually has machine guns, stuff like that. So this is kind of like all the artwork that we're working on currently to try to make the next versions of the game like that much prettier, that much cooler. So yeah, all right, let's see here. All right, so we're just gonna play now. Hopefully that gives you guys kind of like an idea of what the game is, hopefully what it can look like. Obviously there's a big difference between, like, right now where the main thing that we want to do with this game is we want to use Iron Armada as a learning experience of how to organize teams, how to organize development, because right now our artist, he doesn't know any, you know, coding, and obviously our programmer, he couldn't make art like Lucas makes art. So Lucas is making all of these awesome artwork assets, and we're telling each other what we kind of see in the future of the game, like different features that we want, and we're all working together to try and achieve that. So we have all of this beautiful artwork that Lucas has made, but we're still working on figuring out implementation and stuff like that on how to make it. Hold up, let's see here. How to not just have the artwork, but actually incorporate it in the game and have it be bug free and all that stuff. But yeah, that's just an example of what the game can look like. Put it on tablet. I mean, look, I'm gonna be honest. I try to say this on every single one of my streams. I get really, really excited, and I love talking about the potential of things and the future of things. Doesn't necessarily mean that those are all things that we're gonna be able to do. Like, I tell this to everybody, as a developer, as an excitable developer, just assume that I'm always lying. Assume that everything that I'm saying, unless you actually have it in game, is just a lie. Like, it'll be way easier that way for everybody. With that said, people are bringing up like, oh man, will this be on iPhone? Will this be on tablet? I'm sure it could be. I'm sure that is totally possible. I don't know if we want to do that. I don't know if we could do that. I think we could. I think it would be pretty reasonable. I think the control scheme would be kind of fucky and it would be kind of hard to play. But yeah, totally. Do we have any immediate plans to bring it to tablet and iPhone? No. Could we in the future? Possibly. I have no idea. I mean, hell, do you remember when Don't Starve said that it was never going to have multiplayer? I remember that too. So, you know, who knows? All right, so we're just play this game. Alright, what is the plan? Oh, this is a new round, because we lost the last round, right? Because
I was yeah, I don't know if you're on blue or red right now. I think you're red.
I'm on red. Do I need it? This is blue, isn't it? Goddamn.
This is blue, See you later. Good luck, though.
Fuck. Okay, there we go. It's... it scrambles teams every single round. Alright, so we've got our mothership.
Do you
what are we
going to
have? Are we
going to
have like a... Jesus, do you need three reactors? The mothership doesn't even have three reactors. Look at this guy. Fucking greedy over here.
Didn't you steal a reactor from my ship last game?
No. Here, I'll give you another one. Hold up. Let's see. I gotta get rid of these, though.
I found another asteroid, so I'll bring you guys some scrap here.
Imagine a 150-player server with a huge map and dozens of ships with three or more teams. Yeah, absolutely. I mean, those are things that I'm imagining. Now, again, I'm not sure what we'll be able to accomplish. We haven't actually tested how many players are able to be. I think right now we have a artificial maximum. Like, we set it so not more than 32 people can join. We haven't stress tested it, though. Like, I have no idea. Maybe we could get this to, like, 2,000 and be fine. I think the only limit is how powerful the server is, but that is the idea. Like, we want this to be a platform. Right now it's just red versus blue, but I mean the idea is you could turn this into anything. Like, the we really like the multi-crew aspects. We really like the fact that you can build your ships and explore the solar system and stuff like that, and we could totally do that. We've already tested like the planets and the amount of the scope. Like, right now we have an artificial area that you're allowed to be in, and even that area is pretty big, but we've tested it, and we could make that area huge with, you know, as you can see this planet here, we could have multiple planets that you can actually travel to. I mean, it's not like you're gonna be able to land on them. Like, you, like, it's not like they're gonna, some people think that you can land on planets in this game and it turns into like a Rimworld simulator. I mean, not to say that that wouldn't be possible sometime down the road. I don't even know. I haven't even thought about it. Probably. I mean, God, you have to understand, everything's possible. Everything is technically possible. It doesn't mean we can achieve it. But one of the things that would be really cool is, oh shit, we're under attack. Board him. Okay, hold up. Yeah, he backed off. One of the things that would be really cool, especially when we get the next artwork pass done, and you have like really like way prettier ships and also like a lot more different components and things to choose from to put on your ship, you could have it so there's multiple planets in a solar system. Like, let's say every single server is its own solar system. So if you decide to host an Iron Armada server, you can press a generate button and bam, you've got like 7 planets on your server, and it stays that way forever. And as a player, you can go from server to server, and you can go to, you know, quote unquote different solar systems and stuff like that, which have their own, you know, world and their own player base and stuff like that. But in every solar system, there's a bunch of planets, and you can build your ship and you can fly around that solar system, like that giant map that has planets in it, flying from planet to planet, engaging maybe in piracy, trading, having faction wars. Like, hell, right now we have faction wars, red versus blue. It wouldn't take much for us to allow you to dynamically create factions with people that you like. Maybe you have a YouTube streamer that comes into an Iron Armada server and he has a bunch of fans that all join his faction, and then that faction goes around just like dominating and going to war with other factions, like fucking Agario, you know, like that would be awesome. We think that would be really, really cool. So what amount of players can play in a single server? We have no idea. I want to say like at least 50 at least, but we have no idea. We have not stress tested it. And also, we're kind of running this on a poopy server, so maybe you could get a way better server and have like 1,000. I have no fucking clue. But yeah. Oh, another thing, some people are asking how you change your view. So the way you change your view is actually pretty simple. If there is a seat, you get inside that seat, and it automatically... Oh, shit, give me that. Oh, shit. Ooh. Whenever you get into a seat, it automatically just adjusts your view in that direction. So you can have a seat be facing any direction. So you can have... Oh, God damn it. What are you doing? So let's say we're going to put this seat here. Bam, there you go. So if you're a pilot or if you're a gunner, if you're a rear gunner, it'll automatically like... Bzoop. And you see right now we actually need to build the ship a little bit better because we don't have enough thrusters on the right side, which is giving us kind of a problem, thruster problem. Let me finish that up for everybody. Can you stack thrusters on top of each other? So right now you actually can't. So let me show you this. So if you actually build behind a thruster right now, it'll actually... Here, hold up. We'll see if he stops. Damn it. So there you go. There's a corridor block. And if you leave it behind there, the corridor block will actually get just destroyed by the thruster. Because the thruster has backblast. Backwash? Back... I don't know what the fuck to call it. Oh, there's an enemy ship. Here, I can actually turn off... There you go. Turn off the HUD and you can just see the action unfold. And hopefully here in the near future, you know, we'll have like explosion effects and different weapon effects and all sorts of different stuff, so the combat looks like way cooler. Hold on, I'm gonna... Right now, obviously, all the combat is very placeholder and shit. Repair these. Nope. See, this would be a perfect time for us to have a rear... Shit. Oh, crap. This is not good. Okay, this is the part where we go boarding. I'm gonna try to board this guy. Oh, shit, his engines. Oh, shit, his engines just blew me away. Oh, Pasta just got on board. Get him. Yeah, there we go. Fuck yeah. So in this game, you actually have to protect yourself against boarding parties. So you're going to have, like, space marines with jetpacks, you know, flying around. And if they get aboard your ship, like, they can kill you. And they kill you as a pilot, and you can take over their ship and stuff. This is pretty cool. How did you first think of this game? Okay, so the way this game started is my community actually used to host servers for a game called Shipwrecked. It's a mod for King Arthur's Gold. And we really enjoyed the game, but it was frustrating because nobody was playing it. Like, there's literally no Shipwrecked servers right now. I think if there is any Shipwrecked servers, there's only mine, because I was hosting the last one. And we met a couple of the developers, and a bunch of my community members knew Java. And Lucas was an incredible artist, and we were essentially saying, like, you know what, we're so tired of trying to get people to play Shipwrecked because they have to buy King Arthur's Gold, and, you know, there's so many hard-coded limitations on what we can do with this. You know, we can't make this into what we really want it to be. You know, why don't we just make our own game? Like, maybe it's time. Maybe we should make our own game, and we should really see, like, how far we can take this concept of having, you know, multiple people on a single ship. You know, we could do so much with that. It could go so much further than just being, like, a little PvP game mode. And that's how it started. So Iron Armada obviously is still kind of, I don't want to say it's necessarily heavily in development, because it's also like heavily in conceptualization. Like, we have no idea what we want to do. There could be so many things that this could turn into. Like, we're still exploring the possibilities of this game every single day. Holy shit, this is like a huge, massive battle. Oh my god. Oh, I think we're going to win, because we flanked in and they can't get us. Oh, it's over. Get wrecked. Yes. Get the core. Yes.
Yes.
That was sick. Good job.
You guys
job.
Are welcome.
I bet I'm going to be welcome. On the wrong team yeah. last time. Excellent work. So yeah, as you saw there, you know, like our other ship came in behind the enemy ship and just destroyed everything. So it's pretty cool. Where am I reading questions from? I'm reading from chat. Oh, and also a little bit on Steam Greenlight. And Discord. Yeah, okay, never mind. Sucks. We haven't really decided on pricing. We might make it... We don't want it to make it any more than $15, but we also want to develop this game forever. This is the kind of game that I would love to just never stop developing. Like, I would love this game every single year to just be, like, unrecognizably better than it was before. Like, continuing adding art and new blocks and new assets and all sorts of new cool things. So there's a couple different ways that we could do it. We could do like a one-time fee where it's like, okay, you buy the game and you own it forever, and that's great, but then eventually we're gonna have to ditch development of the game, and I don't want to do that. But I also don't want to sit there and milk people for money, you know, every single day. So right now we're kind of thinking of like up in the air, like maybe we could have it so you can purchase the game but have there be other options in order to play it. Some people have been talking about how they really want this game to be like free to play, but we don't want to make a free to play game where you have to like buy in-game things. We think that's lame. We think that you should be able to get whatever the hell you want. Honestly, something that's been working really, really well is like voluntary subscription support. Like, obviously our supporters who subscribe to BlueDrake42.com and back us on even on Twitch and Patreon and stuff like that, like that's huge. So maybe we could find some way to incentivize people to back the game on like something like Patreon and stuff like that, but still have it be, you know, like primarily free for everybody to play. So we don't know, we have no idea. But the one goal that we do know that we want to do is we want this game to be a game that we can continue making for eternity. That's all we know. That's the main goal, hopefully. And we want to do it in a way that doesn't make the game like money hoary or free to play, premium pay to winny or anything like that. We want the game to just be awesome, but we also want to be able to have the support that we need to support our developers and to support development. Yeah, thank you. Thank you so much. So the game's music is actually written by my band's guitarist. If you want to go check out Jahari Official TV on YouTube, I'm the lead vocalist of Jahari. I also am really, really great friends naturally with the guitarist, and we write music together all the time, and we've been writing the soundtrack for Iron Armada, and he's been doing a really, really great job with it, and it sounds beautiful. It's really amazing, because he mainly just writes like heavy metal music and stuff like that. I mean, hell, we both do, but he really has just been making really great soundtracks for Iron Armada. So how about the backstory on why everyone is making ships and killing everyone? So right now this is just for testing. We have no backstory on like who the red and the blue factions are. Ideally, what we would like to do in the future, I'm not a big person on like writing stories. I feel like in games you should write your own stories. You know, like that's the whole point. Like you're writing your own saga. So hopefully, you know, if we ever get to a point where you can host your own server and that server has kind of like an open world to it, you know, the factions that are created on that server who go around and do whatever they want, maybe they'll create their own stories, you know. And in fact, that's kind of cool. You know, imagine if like everybody originally gets on a server and everybody's cool, and then one guy makes a faction, and then, you know, a trade deal goes wrong and they're like, god damn it, fuck those guys, I hate those guys. And then there's like a feud that develops between like gaming clans, and then those gaming clans like try to kill each other and are at each other's throats for a while, and then maybe they come to terms and peace, and like it'd be cool. There's all sorts of stuff that could happen. The music stop? Please don't stop music. Oh, there's like a big long. Oh, we probably bounced that out wrong. Whoops. Just have to reset that every so often. Where are your alien babies? I have no idea. Will players have their own inventory? So that's actually something I've thought of. Here, you know what? I'm gonna let them take over the ship. That's something I've thought about a lot. I played a lot of games when I was younger. Well, what am I talking about? I still play a lot of games. So I was a big fan of the original XCOM, like DOS, like XCOM. I was also a big fan of, you know, Mech Commander Gold and stuff like that. Big fan. What I really, really loved was the inventory with XCOM. Here, let me show you. XCOM inventory. So, here is the old XCOM inventory screen. You know, you had all these different weapons, you have all of these different things, and you could equip your character. And I love this. I love this so much because this game, you know, this game allowed you to micromanage your soldiers, but at the same time, when you were actually in battle, it wasn't like you were overwhelmed with, like, all that. You would essentially give your soldier a loadout, and then that soldier would just go into battle. I really love that idea. I really loved this inventory system. I thought it made everything feel, like, really free, and you could customize your player the way you needed to. You could interact with the environment in really, really meaningful ways. We just lost the game, god damn it. And that's something that we've been experimenting with as well. So let me see if I can find it. Can't show you the source code channel, but I can go down here. So here is an example of some of the weapons that Lucas has been working on. So, you know, in the end game, it would be really cool if there was a variety of weapons that you could get. You know, you could maybe find a derelict ship out in the middle of nowhere, and you'd find, like, a Gauss rifle and some kind of crate, or maybe on, like, a dead guy, or just, like, laying on the ground. You could pick it up, and you could use it in your inventory. You know, also maybe potentially other things, like you have an assault rifle, kind of like Firefly. I was a big fan of the series Firefly. I really love Firefly. Why the hell did you die? Please come back. Please come back before everybody on that cast is dead. But anyways, in Firefly, it was a really awesome blend between modern technology and old technology. I mean, you look at the AK-47, the gun has been around for forever. And that's because, you know, it's hard to, at a certain point, you know, like, a gun is a gun is a gun. If you can use a gun to shoot somebody and you can kill them with it, well, then how fancy and modern does it have to be? You know, maybe for some modern weapons it makes sense to have, but for you know, poor pirates and stuff like that who can't afford that much, maybe, and hell, I don't know, maybe AR-15s are still going to be around, you know, 200 years from now. But that's something that I think we could keep in mind. I'm a developer, so I'm gonna be lying all this time. Who the hell knows what's actually gonna get into the game? But I love just sitting here talking about what's possible. So just keep that in mind. I'm a liar. Don't trust me. But for instance, you know, like this gun, it would be really cool to have, you know, like, clunky old firearms and stuff like that you could still use, but you could maybe also have, like, a modernized version of that firearm that's kind of been, like, updated. Like, for instance, Elysium. I thought Elysium, the movie Elysium, was really, really cool, how they had, like, that AK-47 and then they blended it with modern technology. It's like, oh man, that's so cool. You could potentially have something similar in Iron Armada, or you could find a weapon that is completely different and it is, like, super advanced and it just kills the shit out of everything, but maybe it's really expensive, or maybe its ammo is really rare, or something like that. And then, of course, you could maybe just have something like a goddamn flamethrower. And then another thing that we're looking into is changing the way that you build and repair and stuff like that. We're trying not to, like, completely blatantly rip off things like Space Engineers, but at the end of the day, there's only so many ways you can, like, build and unbuild things. It's not like they have a patent on, like literally saw blades. So that's another thing that we're looking into. You know, like, maybe you have a saw blade for tearing things down faster, or maybe you need it to tear things down, that you could have, like, different welding tools and stuff like that you can customize with your inventory. I don't know, lots of potential. Oh hey, Lucas is in the here. I'm just gonna make Lucas his moderator. Here you go, bam. Hey, thanks for checking out Jahari, man. I appreciate that, dude. Blue Drake is the next Sean Murray. Dude, you might as well just start saying that now. Like, let's just get that out of our system, because it's true. I don't know. Like, it's kind of sad, because I can understand where Sean Murray comes from. Like, I think he was probably just as excited about his game, and he probably got too caught up talking about what the game could be as opposed to what the game actually was. Now, with Iron Armada, that may or may not be the case. I have no idea. It's kind of hard to detach myself from myself and, like, look at what, like... Because obviously I'm biased for my own game. I'm really excited for my own game. But at the end of the day, like, who knows what's going to happen? Who knows? We have no idea. All I know is there's a lot of potential. There's definitely a lot of potential. And we're luckily not signed to anything like Sony, who's going to, like, force us to publish our game before it's ready. So we got that going for us, you know? Lucas is an amazing artist, by the way. He very constantly streams frequently. So, yeah. Guys, stop saying you're being ignored. I can't fucking talk to every single person at the same goddamn time. Come on. You got a lot of people to talk to. Find some. If I'm not answering your questions, you can find somebody else to talk to hear you out. It is physically impossible for me to not ignore at least a large chunk of you. It is literally impossible. Not gonna happen. Can't wait for the first penis ship? What do you mean for the first penis ship? Dude, that happened in fucking pre-alpha. I hate that term, by the way. I hate the word pre-alpha. Everybody uses it nowadays. Like, what even makes a pre-alpha? Like, sometimes I think people call their game pre-alpha, and it's not even, like, officially a pre-alpha. Like, if there is a definition for pre-alpha, I swear to God, there's so many people out there that call their game pre-alpha, and that it has nothing to do with what pre-alpha actually means. Yeah, no. The penis ship happened. You were way late on that. Penis ship, like, right out of the box. First thing we made. In fact, it's kind of funny because a lot of ships in Iron Armada just end up naturally looking like a penis. Like, it's really, you know, because you got, it's a great ship design. It's a great ship design. You got two engine blocks in the back, and then you've got a bulbous bridge at the front with, like, a connecting thing that has, like, guns on the side. Like, it's actually kind of sad, because now we look at a lot of ship designs and we're like, that's a penis. That's still a penis. And the people building it are like, no, it's not. Like, I wasn't even trying to make it look like a penis this time. You're like, no, it's totally a penis. So this doesn't look like a penis. It could, though, if we actually applied ourselves. Will this be like an MMO or something? I don't know. Like, define MMO. What does MMO mean? Is DayZ an MMO? Is DayZ an MMO? I have no idea. It could be like DayZ. Like, look at how many people are in here. We got like 32 people or something like that. Imagine if we made this game kind of like an open world where you could take your ship around, you could trade goods and stuff like that, but there was still only 32 players in a server. Just like DayZ. Does that make it open world? Could. I have no idea. Or sorry, does that make it an MMO? I have no idea. I have no idea. I have no idea. Do people make swastikas in Iron Armada? Yes. God. All the time. It's annoying. But luckily, they aren't a tactic. They don't give you a tactical advantage anymore. No, yes. No, they gave you a tactical advantage in the past. Because what people were doing was they would make a swastika, and then they would put engines on every corner, and that was before we had fictional drag, and then they would make the swastika spin around like super fast, and then they would propel it at people, and it would hit the ship, and it would knock the ship like super far out of bounds. Yeah, so we patched it, so people don't make that anymore. It is kind of interesting though to see, like, whenever we patch the game, and then whenever you patch the game, the ship designs change. Like, we used to have it so the thrusters didn't burn things that were behind them. So what people would do is they would just, like, line thrusters up, and it looked kind of lame. It looked kind of cheap. So then we just made it so the thrusters burn whatever's behind them, and now all the ships look like way cooler just because we just changed the way that the blocks function. So it's interesting to see how the block attributes change ship design, and I'm sure that's going to continuously change as time goes on. Yes, we do have a Steam greenlight. If you want to greenlight us, make sure you click on the link below. Hold up, and then go here, your submissions, Iron Armada. Make sure, I mean, you can say whatever you want to say. I don't want them to think that I'm manipulating votes. But if you want to see Iron Armada on Steam, you click yes. And if you want to, hopefully you can follow and favorite. I mean, we're hoping to have our forums on Steam so you can suggest things on Steam, so you can bug report on Steam, so you can see news. So if you follow this, hopefully you'll be able to keep track. And then, of course, please leave a comment so everybody knows that you are a real person and not just somebody that I like either like paid or intimidated to go press the yes button or something like that. Cause I'm not paying anybody, not doing anything. There's no bots. There's no giveaways. There's nothing right now. Nothing. So you can't argue against, I don't know if I'm allowed to show you the item stats. I think I said how many upvotes we had last time, but I don't know what we're allowed to show actually. So I'm just not going to do that. Boop. Back to Iron Armada. So as you can see right now, we are mining asteroids. That's the way the game works. So at the beginning of the round, there are asteroids that randomly spawn throughout the map. The objective is to build a ship, and then you take the ship and you can shoot up the asteroids and you get money from shooting the asteroids. Once you have... There's only so many asteroids on the map. So at a certain point, there's no more asteroids left. All the asteroids have been mined and there's no more asteroids. But at that point, you can still actually attack enemy ships and get resources by destroying enemy ships and salvaging their parts. So it's actually kind of cool. It's almost like Osmos. Did you guys ever play Osmos? Except, I mean, obviously a much more like militarized version of Osmos. Kind of more of conceptual similarity to Osmos. But all of these different ships go around harvesting resources, and then at the end there's like these giant ships that go to battle. And if you blow up different ships, you can get their resources and expand your own ship, etc. So yes. Yes, I do love my own game. Look, it's funny. I have to tell you, there is kind of like a rift between the kinds of games that I cover and the kinds of games that I like. Not to say that I don't like the games that I cover, but I have a lot of other games outside of what I cover that I enjoy a lot. Like, I loved FTL, but every time I stream FTL, nobody wants to watch FTL. But that doesn't mean I don't love that game. And Iron Armada now is one of those things, you know, like, I'm sure if I had made, like, a military shooter or something like that, that would be more successful on my channel. But I don't want to do that. I wanted to make something that I wanted. And I also didn't want to make something that everybody's just like, oh, okay, here's another freaking cash grab shooter. Like, I wanted to make something original, something that I really wanted to play, something that didn't exist. And that's what Iron Armada is for me. Iron Armada is probably one of the most unique things that I feel like I could bring to the table. And it's something that I'm really, really excited about to play, because it's the kind of game that I've really wanted to play, not just by myself, but with my community for a long time. Because that's a big problem with my channel, is all of these games that I play, that would be way more fun if my community could just log in and play with me. Like, that makes it so much better. Yeah, sorry, the servers are full. Oh, wait, no, there's two spots remaining. But you can't always watch. Yes, you can use the thrusters offensively, and I actually have done that on many occasions. You can actually set it up so if you put like a thruster on the front, you can have a whole bunch of thrusters in the back and then simultaneously burn back and front. And since the front doesn't have as much thrust as the back, you still go forward and you can use these thrusters to burn off the enemy ships. It's fucking awesome, actually. Let me get that little piece. Oh, shit. Here we go. There we go to war. All right, so we've got two ships. Let me get on the bridge here. 3v1, but they've got a pretty big ship. Although it looks like they've got a... Oh, shit. 4v1. It's over. Is that the... Yep, that's the core ship. That is the mothership. So we were about to engage the mothership. It's about to go down. So we've got our mothership in the back. We've got two corvettes on the side and kind of like a fighter, like a heavy fighter in the front. They're sending space marines after us, but this is not going to work. It's over. It's over. We're totally going to win this one. All their crew is trying to get back into the core and protect their reactor. No, it's over. It's over. GG. GG. Get wrecked. Die. 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 Gotta kill the people. Guys, kill the... Kill the crew around you. There we go. Hey, hold up. Did I mute or unmute? I don't even know.
You're unmuted in the wrong chat.
Yeah. Oh, shit.
Much fun.
There we go. What was I talking about? Oh, right, hold on. No, I have to get my... You to come back up. Yeah, I mean, it would be cool in the future if you could have, like, ship... If you could have... I mean, obviously, so in the future, what we're hoping to have is different sizes of ships, different power systems, so you actually have to have an engine room and stuff like that. Jesus, look at how many of this that there are. You could totally do all those things. Are there spikes or ramps? Again, not yet, but... besides, you could actually use the engine strategy, so... I guess I could say yes there. There we go. God damn it. I guess we're going the other way. What are we doing? Ah, fuck. Who keeps deleting the reactor? Am I gonna have to start breaking out the ban hammer?
Oh yeah.
Yeah. Please do.
Do it.
Okay, somebody put down a reactor and then don't delete it, or Banhammer is gonna start fucking swinging on the server.
Goddamn.
Come on, I put down the reactor with my resources, just please put it back.
Blue Drake, can I call you daddy?
Here, if you put down the reactor, you can, come on.
Sorry, Blah. Mothership is more important.
Come on, reactor, please. Thank you.
All right,
wait.
Go.
You can just hit right click on this. Oh my god, I'm stupid.
Someone please make it.
Next patch is gonna make it so you can't do that. So it's
can't
not
do what?
Just delete things that aren't yours.
Oh yeah, that's great. Still not even.
You're fine.
How can
I okay.
You just right click on everything.
How can I become a
Marine? All right, there we go.
X.
Right in front of you.
Yeah, I see it. Oh, big one.
So about the AI of pre-generated ships. So this is like, I don't even want to talk about it because it's so freaking conceptual. We do have artwork for it though. We have a floppy disks artwork. So if you guys know, in Space Engineers, you actually have the ability to there's programmable blocks. And essentially what happens is when you place down a programmable block, there's a text file inside of it, and you can write whatever code you want. And I believe it accepts Lua, and you can use that code to operate the ship. So you can essentially write AI for the ship, which is really cool. So an idea that we had, and essentially what we'd have to do this pretty cleverly in order to keep the server from overloading. But we would have a similar block. So you'd have like an AI core or something like that, or like a computer terminal or something like that. And what you would have is you'd have a floppy disk on that computer core. And what you could do is you could actually take that floppy disk out and put it in your inventory and go around with it. And that floppy disk would have Lua code or whatever code you would want put onto it. Oh, god damn it. Somebody... and you could actually take that floppy disk, write software on it that uses the ship, and then put it into a computer core, and then have that computer core run whatever code was on that floppy disk, that digital fake floppy disk, that inventory item floppy disk. And what that means is not only would you be able to write code for your ship that operates as an AI, but you could actually trade software with other players. So like, let's say you've got like an automated AI cannon system, like an automated firing system. So you've got like this code that takes control of the remote ships and you know, automatically fires the weapons and stuff like that. You could actually go to somebody and be like, hey, I've got this software. It's like cannon auto aim mark one or something like that, or like you know, remote fire script Mark II or something like that. You'd be like, hey, I can give you this and you can go install it on your ship. And they could go do that. Now, the problem with this, obviously, is if we allowed everybody to run software on the server, it would crash the server, because the server is not going to be able to run the game and all of the AI. I mean, hell, somebody could probably abuse it and make it so the AI core, you know, runs like a program that breaks the game or something like that. But something we have thought about doing and maybe could do is we could make it so the AI scripts that you write and that you plug into your ship run client side. So what would happen is, so right now the way this game works is, I know it kind of looks like the game is running on my computer, but it's actually not. The game is running on the server, and then my player is sending input in order to adjust the player position on the server. It's a little bit more complicated than that, but I'm just gonna... Oh, look at this guy pussying out. Look at you pussying out. That's another thing that we have to patch in the next build. Make it so players can't delete their own blocks as quickly, so they don't just pussy out and run when they're getting fucked. Kill this guy. die. But yeah, so the game is actually, the server is actually the master game, and players are actually sending input. So, and, God damn it, hold up. Go away. The players, when they play with their client, are sending input to the server, and then the server is the one calculating all the physics and maintaining the position of all the ships and telling all the players where they are and stuff like that. Which is also why we're able to have everything be super, super stable. It's one of the reasons all the players aren't falling off the ship and doing all sorts of other stuff. Now, with that said, another thing that we could do is have it so you run the AI scripts for your ship on your own computer, and then the AI sends commands to the ship the same way that you do. The only difference is that, well, it's a script. It automatically does it. Which is pretty cool. So we could actually have it so you could program your own AI that operates the ships remotely on the server. So yeah, totally possible, very conceptual. I am not saying that that is going to be in the game at all. It probably won't. I have no idea, but that is potential, and it was a cool idea that we were thinking of. We were actually thinking of this before Dual Universe announced, because Dual Universe, I think, has something like similar that they wanted to do. And we saw that and we were like, oh, hey, that's interesting. We were thinking about doing that. But also Space Engineers does it as well, so it's not really like an original idea. Okay, their mothership is up here. We're going to try to get in to engage this. I think that ship was way faster than we were. Oh, Space Marines. Oh, actually not Space Marines. I think they're just trying to build. All right. Oh shit. Oh shit. Oh shit. Nope. 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 Oh, this is bad. This is bad. We gotta get out of here. Oh, come on. Come on. Come on. Ooh, good thing we're faster than him. Look at all the people on that ship, though. Like, that is a fully crewed ship. There's at least, like, 20 people on that ship. Okay, not 20 people, because that doesn't make sense. At least, I don't know, like, what, 10? I mean, that's their main mothership, so it makes sense. And you see how the way their ship is designed. They've got those engine blocks that are far away from their center of mass, so that actually makes them more maneuverable than us, which is kind of a problem. Okay, so we are also having a problem. We've got more thrust on the left side. There we go. Okay, he's got it. Come on, make that engine go online, please. There we go, perfect. Now we're going straight. Make sure I'm in the right Discord channel. Hey, yo, guys, I know where their mothership is. Everybody here, come with me. Who's this? Proflow, Victory, guys, on me. I know where their mothership is. Follow me.
All right.
Let's go. Form up!
Marines, get ready. The rest stay on repair duty.
Let's see, wait, hold on.
All ships form up on Admiral Blue Drake.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. Iron Armada if I've ever seen one. Alright, they should be here. Dante, go forward and scout. I think you're faster than us. Maybe not, I don't know. Scanning. There they are. Guys, I need you to take a right, go hard right. Okay, mothership's gonna stay in the back. See, this is the cool shit. This is the emergent gameplay that I love. I'm now gonna command this fleet in battle.
Marines, go in front.
No, hold up. I'm staying in the back. We're gonna engage this guy. Oh shit. Okay, I need more ships on me. More ships on me. He's coming. Incorp, get behind him. Get behind him. He's coming for us. Shit. Are we gonna try to pass him up? Oh, perfect. Yes. Are we got him surrounded?
Got him.
Aim for the center. Aim for the core. He's got that reactor block right there in the front. His reactor's about to be exposed. Aim for the reactors. Reactors, now.
Repair.
It's over, dicks. It's over. Aim for the core.
Getting boarded.
Wait, we are? Shit. It is over. Reactors down. It's over. Mop it up. God, there's so many. Aim for the core. Oh, shit. Oh, I just went down.
Behind us, I just saw him. He's gone.
God, there's so many of them. Aim straight for the core.
Oh my god.
All those so many of them. The core.
It's a fucking bloodbath.
God, remind me that we still haven't implemented spawn times. We just need to have like a 5-second spawn time.
Yeah, they just respawn in an instant.
It's going down. It's dark.
It's going down. Just keep shooting it.
They're repairing it. They're actually repairing it.
Yeah, keep shooting it.
Repair our ship.
Profi just ripped off part of our ship.
Full auto.
Oh my god.
Finally.
There we go. Jesus Christ.
As soon as we have
respawn times, that will be way better. Okay, so, yeah, right now we have it, so obviously there's no respawn time, so you just instantly respawn, so they were just sitting there repairing it. Now, we've never had this many people on a server, so, obviously it's unbalanced to begin with, so we need to patch that, but yeah. Yes, we do have a Steam Greenlight. Go upvote us on Greenlight. Hold up, goddammit, wrong fucking... Go away. This one, yeah. Go here, you can upvote us on Steam Greenlight. Yes. Followed, favorite, tell the world that you love us. This guy's apparently a view bot. God damn it, pieces of shit. This is a fake account. Dicks! Whatever, go do it! See, hold up, I'm gonna look. Privately look at the item stats. Holy shit, 6,500. We're almost there! Get to 10,000 eventually. It's gonna happen. Of course it. Oh, holy shit. Fuck. Alright. New game. Yeah, it does look kind of like GTA 2. That wasn't like a design. That wasn't like an intentional thing. It wasn't like, oh man, let's make GTA 2. But it does. It does look like that. Okay, we got a big asteroid over here. Hold on, make sure I'm in the right Discord channel again. Damn.
Oh, yes, right. I can.
There is a giant here. No, don't go for that one. There's a larger asteroid to the up here.
There's a larger dick in your mouth.
Don't say that. That is inappropriate. This is a community of maturity and respect. Like, obviously, if you watch my channel, you know I am one of the utmost mature and respectful individuals.
Sure you are.
Don't fucking lie.
I'm six.
Yeah, damn straight you are. Alright. So
there's an asteroid.
Let's get this shit mined. I know. That's why I came here, dude.
Where are you? I want to give you all my scrap.
I don't know how to tell you. We're on, I don't know how to fucking... They were trying to navigate with, like, say, a clock size shit of the planet, but I don't know how the fuck that works.
Did you like that mass, repair last round.
Yeah, fuck you. Fuck you. God. If we had respawn times in already, y'all would have died. I mean, I guess it's kind of balanced, because it means we have to have, like, a hella advantage in order to win. You can't just have the Corby sniped.
You probably fix that problem where we both sit in the seat.
Yeah, I know! I'm gonna, look, you know what? I'm gonna... Blue Drake plays pre-alpha card. It is very effective. I'm just gonna sit here and chill out to Iron Armada soundtrack music now. Soundtrack is only half done. The rest of it will be done when the game is released, hopefully.
Yeah, by the way, how long will it take for you guys to implement sound effects?
As soon as we find a sound person who is good. So, that, like, I have no sound person right now. Like, I'm literally, I have no one. So, we're either gonna buy them, or somebody's gonna make them, or something. So, that's the idea. Right now, like, honestly, if we put sound in this right now, it would probably, like, be painfully bad. So, like, unless we get the sound to be good, I'm not fucking with it. Because look at how fast these lasers are firing. Could you imagine if it was like, pew, 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 like, Jesus. We have to, if we're going to have sound, it needs to be, like, good.
Make the sound yourself.
Like, yeah, perfect. Just implement that. I'm just going to snip that out of my live stream, and then we're going to just put it in.
I think I know a sound guy, but I have to talk to him.
Show him to me, because I need sound. I had this one Russian sound guy who was making pretty sick sounds, but I never got in touch with him.
Mushroom.
No, what? No, not mushrooms. Mushrooms are coder.
I used to be in a game creating community. I think there are a few guys there that create sounds.
Yeah, hit me up with anything.
Yeah, okay. I'll contact him.
Who's this guy? Dante over here. Run, Dante! Run! What the fuck is Alex doing? What the fuck is...
Hey, Blue Drake, turn right. We got an asteroid.
No, fuck that. I'm gonna kill Dante. He's over here with his tiny little, like, escape pod, essentially. God, you're so fucked, Dante. See, look at that. Look at him trying to steal his shit. Can't wait to patch that. Oh, yes, VOIP. Obviously, as you guys know, VOIP is a huge deal for me. I really think that all games should have solid VOIP. That is totally a high priority for me. I absolutely want to have VOIP in the game, but honestly, VOIP implementation and integration is almost going to be like a game in itself. Like, that is going to be its own project. And I want it to be good. And obviously, we want to have, like, squad... not squad, like... Well, no, I guess kind of squad. I don't really know how to say it. Like, we want to have it so a crew of players, you know, like, we want to have it so everybody on this ship is on one channel, and then we want to have it so maybe, like, there's, like, a captain channel where you can hail other ships or communicate with other, like, carriers and destroyers and stuff like that, and other ships. So, you know, kind of, maybe kind of like Project Reality, where you have, like a squad radio, and then you have, like, a command radio or something like that, so you can, and except in this, you'd be able to communicate with all the people on your ship, or you'd be able to communicate, with other ships and stuff like that. So yeah, totally high priority. Not sure when that'll be able to be done. That is not something that we're working on right now, obviously, because we want the game to be good before everything else is done. Alright, anybody
find it? Oh
no. I just took out Proflow, he was mining.
RIP.
Wait, don't leave me.
How is Project Reality going? I have no idea. I mean, I guess it's going. They just released a map pack, but go check up on go check up on PR. That's their shit. I mean, I don't know. I don't run PR. I didn't make PR.
Where did these two reactors go?
Fucking Alex.
Hey, replace those batteries with reactors if you can.
Alright.
Which battery?
The ones in the front. There's one more left. Okay, good. Yeah, no, we're still low on power. Probably. No, don't.
Will we implement ramming? Yeah, probably. I don't know. Actually, the balance for not having players be able to ram has been pretty good recently. So if we do implement ramming, it'll be like a very calculated implementation that will be balanced. So yeah, right now it works totally fine without having that main. Guys, I have them. Light side of the planet. Light side of the planet. Go, 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 go.
Oh yeah, they're the. Oh my god.
Yeah, they.
Guys,
have
you hear? There's an entire fleet here.
If it comes down to it, mass repair.
Shit.
Blue Drake, turn.
I know. I also don't want the mothership to come at us.
I think he's gonna grab our ass if we turn.
Got him. He's down. Good kill.
I'll thrust this forward and get us into close range.
Yep.
Got him. Nice. You got destroyed.
Alright, let's mop him up.
Behind us.
Behind us? Shit. Okay, alright. I see it. Hold up. We see the mothership. We're coming in. Distract him. Guys, get that debris off. Okay, good. Alright, coming in.
Hey, get rid of the extra weight on the left.
Guys, focus on the mothership. Mothership.
Check
okay.
The shaft.
Okay, reactors exposed. Go for the reactor. Goodbye, motherfucker.
Repair.
Hey, whoever's in the cockpit, go full forward burn. Full forward burn.
They're coming on. Heat repair, Ghost. Don't let them come through.
Whoa, who's that? Oh shit, they have a destroyer? Oh, that's not good. That's not good. Everybody go board that destroyer. Oh, we have to get behind it.
Repair.
Focus on the guns. Hold it, focus on the center. Concentrate fire center. Get the pilot. Got him. He's down.
Nice.
Marines, watch it, they're boarding. Left and right.
Alright, there
okay,
you go.
Turning around. Okay, hold up. I can't aim very well. I can't turn left. I'm fucking Zoolander over here.
Watch out. Marine behind us.
Okay, hold up.
Mothership is
dead. Oh, get on the left. Repair, come on. Go.
Alright, focus. Focus fire. Just keep this up. If they're gonna waste all their armor, we're just gonna get the credits. This is endgame now. Focus all fire on the core.
Marine.
Marine incoming.
Get him. Left. Here, I have an idea. There we go. There we go.
Holy
get
shit.
The core away from them.
They're gonna board. Keep repairing.
Hold up, I can't get away. Watch Gaz.
Our core is fully exposed right now.
No,
build walls around
we're
it.
We're fine. Got it.
Nice.
Good kill. Alright, let's see how long we've been streaming. About an hour and a half. Alright, well, you know what? I think we're going to end it here. Thanks so much for watching, guys. I hope you enjoy this. Make sure you go and upvote Iron Armada on Steam right here. Make sure you follow it, favorite, do all those things, and hopefully we'll get on Steam. So, yeah. Alright, I will see you guys next time. Thanks so much for watching, and, yeah. Hopefully we get on Steam.